So I get a lot of stick about my little hammer and looking for delamination on people's boats at pre-purchase, but I just thought I'd show you a very simple little exercise using a ball peen hammer. It's a very small one. This actually was my dad's. It's a little 4 ounce one. You can buy similar things on the dreaded eBay, I know, and other sites, but people worry about using metal hammers on gel coat, and to be honest with you, a lot of it is nonsense, because if the ball is clean and you know what you're doing, you won't ever damage the top sides. And I should point out that the first thing that ever happens to a GRP boat when it comes out of a plug is someone goes across it with a hammer to literally check all the returns like this, very gently, to make sure there's no voids in any of the returns or chine points. Now I know that because that's 15, 16, that's one of my first jobs in the boatyard when we laminated the boat. Now, so top sides, I've got a little bit of delamination here, and I'm going to just show you the difference in sounds so you get an idea. So here we go. So this is good laminate, and as I work up, very gently tapping it, as you work up, you'll start to hear a difference. So I know that there's delamination there. And the surprising bit is, if you look closely, you can see some little gel coat fracturing here, or crazing, and it's actually quite a long way away from where the delamination was. So basically, where the boat had the impact was probably about here, but behind there, there's probably a bit of support, and it's taken some time for it to ping off above it. So as you can see, it's not particularly big. In this particular case, where it is, I'd be tempted probably not to do a lot with it, but just to keep an eye on it and use a moisture meter to make sure it doesn't get particularly high in moisture. If it does, there is a risk in the winter of it popping off and starting to blow and creep further. So it is important to know the difference of serious delamination and light delamination. But that's really it. I'll just do it once more so you get an idea. Also, it's important where you hold the hammer. I always like a long handle. And so you get this bit of a rocking on it, so you get an idea, and you'll also get a hang of how it bounces. You know, there it's just very gentle, and coming up you'll see the difference straight away, and you see there's a little bounce in it as I just do it. And I say this is very gentle hammering, it's nothing particular. One thing that's worth pointing out also with tap testing is that laminate you know, generally it is 12, 15 mil thick. You will only get down with a hammer lightly to about 6 or 7 mil. After that, you've got to start using a little bit more force with the hammer if you think there was an issue. But again, that's all comes with experience. Hope you found that interesting. Cheers.